It's been a few years. I am sorry, I didn't even recognize Alicia. Thank God for mercy. We'd all be in trouble. Alicia's wonderful. And for all that are here, thank you. What of your brother Jim? I know there was a little lady that was pursuing brother Jim, and I said, well, you call him. And I said, you call him. And, you know, it thrills me. I gotta be honest, I'm not surprised, because I know the love that's there. So, Sister Margie, would you come? You seem to have been chosen to be first.
Well, I was gonna be the only one, so I guess I should still be first, but yeah.
That's right. Come right up here and join me, and you can share from right here.
Pastor, I don't mean to correct you, but when you mentioned before Gail went up to sing that it was a request, Gail offered to sing, and I thank God for all the love Gail has for everyone here.
Oh, yeah.
She's quite a little girl for 15 years old.
Amen.
Yes.
Quite a woman, I'm sorry.
A beautiful young lady.
Yes. A little girl.
I won't say the other words, because I can hear the other words say right here.
I don't care if you want to.
I'm changing now. They're young ladies. I appreciate that, sister. And again, I thank God for young people that know they're a part of something.
Amen.
It's eternal. Welcome. Isn't she beautiful?
Yeah.
Now, her husband's not here, but you can tell him, because I thank God that statement is seen beyond the physical.
Amen.
Beyond the physical.
Amen.
I thank God he prepares us to be one in the spirit. And when God does a work in man's life, they are beautiful. I don't care, man, woman, and child, they are beautiful. And thank God for that beauty. So, sister.
I don't really want to take a long time because I know there's four others, but I really don't want to be rushed.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you won't be.
Because this is one of the greatest moments of my life.
Hallelujah.
Among many.
Yes.
If it weren't for my mom and dad, I wouldn't have been born and I wouldn't have been here.
Yes.
And I would come very much.
Hallelujah.
And I want everyone here to know that if it weren't for Ruth, we wouldn't be here.
Hallelujah.
Because she's the first example of a true Christian woman I've ever met.
Glory be to God.
See, she doesn't know, maybe, but she was only born again 2 years before I was. Many of you think I'm a new Christian, but I'm not. I was born again on November 17th of 1973, and that was 24 years ago, I believe.
Hallelujah.
I was 26 years old, and I was quite an arrogant young lady. And I was going through a divorce, and I was in an apartment raising a little boy all by myself, and I was very broken.
Hallelujah.
And that's when I asked Christ to come into my heart.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now I can tell everybody here I haven't always walked the walk, but I haven't talked it either because I don't like legalism and I've never been a part of that, but believe me, I've had my errors in other ways. I heard something here a few weeks ago and it just excited me to death, and that was the fact that, see, first of all, I didn't think I could have any better relationship with my son than a mother to a son. But I've got a better relationship because he's my brother in Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's a higher calling. That's
yes.
More than I could ever ask for.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Sure is.
And
just
I also,
as graceful on this side of the wall too.
This Tuesday, Kurt will have been baptized 8 months ago. And when he came out of the baptismal, he came over to me and just kind of looked at me gently and said, Mom, you're next. You know, I've been pretty quiet all this week, and I wanted God to prepare me, and I kept thinking, well, maybe I'm supposed to go into the scriptures and read all this stuff, and I kept saying no, that probably would be too religious. But tonight I had a, and today I had a whole day pretty much by myself without my husband, and God prepared that whole day.
Hallelujah.
And I went home tonight and I was alone, and in the late afternoon after I went to awaken, I was compelled to go pick up this old Bible I had from Bill's mother. And I asked God from the bottom of my heart to just show me the words that I wanted to really express to people.
Hallelujah.
And I opened it up, and I opened it to Matthew. And there it is, exactly what I need to tell people. Jesus said in there, if you will confess me before men, I will confess you to my Father.
Hallelujah.
And if you deny me before other men, you will be denied
yes,
to my
Father.
Father. And all my life I felt left behind and left out. And I'm not going to be left. I'm not going to be denied this.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
The worst thing I think I could ever hear is Jesus facing me one day and saying, go away, I never knew you.
Yeah.
I want to know him. I want all
Amen.
He's got for me.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
So, with that I say, Jesus is my Lord and Savior. And I thank God for him.
Hallelujah.
I thank God for the Holy Spirit. I thank God for all the love here.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. She is beautiful, isn't she?
Yeah.
Amen.
Everyone is special. Everyone is special. I mean, you take every life here. You know what I love about God? Every life is special. There's not one that can take another's place. No one can replace us. And when we see that, and that's not because of any position we have, it's because God created each one of us as an individual. And he wants us to be in liberty.
I found that out twice already in my life.
God never fails. Well, sister, upon your confession of Jesus as the Christ, the Son of the living God, and your Savior, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.